Protesters call Spain's King Felipe and the royal family murderers while pelting him with mud and other objects. This after what locals call botched and slow alerts once their government learned of the dangers of impending catastrophic flooding to the country's Valencia region, where mobile alerts sounded 2 hours too late. Coupled with what they call a slow response by emergency services, these became the deadliest flash floods in Spain's recent history, claiming more than 200 lives. Spain's prime minister said Saturday the government was sending 5,000 more troops to join the 2,500 already deployed for search, rescue, and cleanup operations. He added plans to seek assistance from the European Union's Solidarity Fund.
Y soy consciente de que la respuesta que se está dando no es suficiente.
I am aware that the responses that is being given is not enough. I know that there are severe problems and shortages, that there are collapsed services, municipalities buried in mud, desperate people looking for relatives, and homes destroyed and buried by mud. I know we have to do better and that we have to give our all, but I also know that we have to do it together.
Spanish police released aerial videos showing the widespread destruction of storms that dumped more rain in 8 hours than the preceding 20 months. When waters receded, locals saw their homes destroyed, many packed with mud and cars stacked atop one another in the streets. Climate scientists say such extreme weather events will only increase as climate change worsens.
Spain has been hit by absolutely catastrophic flooding. So if you can, you know, imagine a watering can, you turn the nozzle, you get a shower, you remove the nozzle, you get a heavier downpour, you take a bucket and it comes down on you, you know, torrentially. And this is what has been happening this week in Spain.
By Saturday, thousands of volunteers arrived outside Valencia's iconic City of Arts and Science complex. They traveled by bus to join those already taking part in cleanup efforts in areas where nearly a week after floods struck, many people still don't have access to clean drinking water. All while national police wade through shoulder-high water in search of those still missing. Arash Arabasadi, VOA News.